from Hawthorne, California. The Beach Boys.
Out on the West Coast, a new sound was born, the surfing sound.
It was awesome.
Oh, it was a thrill. Are you kidding? I was out of my mind.
Wild times and sexual exploits.
The optimism, the hope, the dreams.
Your sole purpose was to sing.
The stream of hits seemed endless.
Behind the scenes, the Beach Boys were going through all kinds of hell. Spats.
Murray would come out on the road with us and be the manager. Bad idea.
Legal spats.
I was cheated by my cousin and my uncle.
Breakdowns.
I stayed in my room for about 3.5 years.
Drugs.
I knew that Denny would probably never die of old age.
The influence of drugs completely obliterated the hit machine that the Beach Boys had been.
I am finishing my last semester in school in 12th grade.
When we first started out, the rock music business had not exploded. We'd go out with a station wagon.
And they would eat hamburgers on stage.
The four of us would just sit there and just harmonize, and we loved it.
Here they are, the Beach Boys with Surfin' Safari.
And then it wasn't just 500 or 1,000 people anymore. It was 10,000, 50,000 people.
And as you can hear in the background, the girls are still hollering for them.
The Beach Boys, and I was their music teacher 20-some years ago, were average, red-blooded American young boys. They had their problems, sometimes not in class when they're supposed to be.
It was pretty exciting to check out England, Germany, Japan, Scandinavia, and be treated like stars.
Well, East Coast girls are hit by really.
Murray still was trying to control them.
He was overbearing to us personally.
Telling you when and where to be and finding you if you're late. We hated the fines.
He only knew how to do it on his terms.
Brian, what's the matter? You made too much money, buddy? When you guys get too much money, you start thinking you're going to make everything again.
Brian's frustrated and hurt, insecure.
Murray told him that he would never be a man.
You had your first nervous breakdown, correct?
Right.
When was that, Brian?
I never saw it as a nervous breakdown, but they all called it a nervous breakdown. And he just knew that he could not go on the road. That was not his thing.
In 1969, Murray sold the publishing rights to his son's songs.
And he said, "You can't sell my songs." And his father said, "Well, I did, because they're never going to amount to anything."
The family feud, a question of who put the surf in those surfer songs.
I wrote all the words.
Round, round, get around, I get around, I'm picking up good vibration.
I was completely blindsided. I was relying upon Brian as my cousin and Murray as my uncle to protect me. I had no idea that they would set out to screw me. And then as Brian's mental issues got worse, it became very clear that I didn't have any standing.
Who was responsible in the 1965 period for copyrighting the songs?
My father.
You were in bed for over 3 years, weren't you?
Yeah, 2.5, 3 years.
My point of view about drugs and its influence on the Beach Boys is it's the most destructive thing that could have possibly been.
Dennis Wilson led an often troubled life. He had a long-time problem with alcohol and was often absent from recent Beach Boys tours.
Dennis Wilson picked up one of the Manson family girls hitchhiking, and he ended up going out to Spahn Ranch. Charlie passed out, I guess LSD, and Dennis was trying to get us all to join the family. He had Charlie actually living with him.
Dennis Wilson went diving, and an hour later, the body was brought out of the Pacific Ocean he celebrated in song.
If more than half of the group screwed up, then there's not much you can do other than hold on to your own personal integrity and keep with what you know to be good for you.
Now, Mike was very spontaneous when it came to writing lyrics, isn't that correct?
Yes, he was.
He kind of has a genius for that.
Right.
Where he just listened to your music and take out a pad and spit lyrics, isn't right. that true?
True.
Beach Boy Mike Love rode a legal wave to victory in his battle against cousin Brian Wilson.
Today's verdict goes a long way towards getting myself and Brian back together, believe it or not, ironically enough.